Dear students, now we are going to discuss a various assumption that is made for the Fourier's law. There are five different assumptions that we made for derivations of Fourier's law. Before we are going to discuss the general heat conduction in the three-dimensional, we need to refer this assumption. First assumption, here we made that heat transfer takes place under the steady state conditions. Steady state condition, it means mathematically, if we represent these conditions, then dT by d tau will be equals to zero. Here we are using the tau is notation for the time, because we already used T for the temperature. Implies that if the temperature T we consider in the three dimensional, then the temperature is functions of x, y and z, that is three coordinates. Now we are going to discuss the second assumption, that is there is no internal heat generation. It means the heat cannot be generated from inside of body. Third, the material is homogeneous and isotropic. Homogeneous, it means the throughout the body, the properties, the thermal properties are remains constant. And in isotropic, it means in particular directions, the thermal properties are remains constant. Suppose we consider in isotropic, isotropic, it means in different directions, the properties like thermal conductivity, densities, viscosities are remains constant. This kind of object is called as isotropic. Fourth one, there is unidirectional heat flow. This is very important. We can say this is very important assumptions, that the heat is transferred in only unidirectional. Because we cannot apply the Fourier's law when the heat is transferred in more than one direction. Or if heat is transferred in more than one direction, we are only able to apply the Fourier's law for only a single direction. Then fifth one, the temperature distribution profile in that uniform directions or the unidirection is a linear. It means a straight line distributions of thermal distributions, or we can say the temperature distributions are there. So this is overall the assumption that we made for derivations, or before we apply the Fourier's law.